Fair, spoiler-free reviews of the newest films. Vaughn on Movies.
Featuring music from The Escape Club. Check them out on Facebook for information about their new album. When a job is too dangerous, there is only one mercenary team you can turn to. The Expendables. They are led by Barney Ross, played by Sylvester Stallone, who is multitasking as director and co-writer. His number one guy is Lee Christmas, played by Jason Statham, and rounding out the team are Dolph Lundgren, Jet Li, Randy Couture, and Terry Crews. For $5 million in cash, they are going to overthrow a rogue CIA operative named James Monroe, Eric Roberts, who has seized a small island that, let's say it together, is involved in drug trade. This movie actually has the Terminator, Rambo, and Die Hard all in the same scene. Arnold shows up and he's all like, "CIA got you pushing too many pencils." And then Sylvester Stallone, he's all like, "Yo." And then Bruce Willis, he's all like, "Welcome to the party, pal. I'm getting a little clamped. Talk amongst yourselves, I'll give you a topic. John Rambo versus John Matrix. Discuss."
The world's toughest movie critic.
There's so much testosterone on hand, you can cut it with a machete, but unfortunately too many of the actors play the same character. Sure, one may prefer a knife to a kick, but they're all jockeying for the hero position. There are so many heroes to cut to in the middle of the action that I was oftentimes confused as to what was happening. And a lot of these action scenes are made possible by your standard supply of soldiers who stand around and don't fire their guns. To round up all these action film stars, you think they need a killer script. Well, guess again. Even for the genre, this plot involving a rogue CIA operation cultivating drugs on an island is below par. And the only time the story gets interesting is when there's a plot hole. So Ross and Christmas fly in on this giant plane to do some recon. They come across this girl who's helpful, and she refuses to leave with them, which of course is a great reason to go back. And speaking of their return, I don't know how these guards missed this giant plane the second time around. There's also a scene where Eric Roberts is really frustrated that this girl's a painter, yelling, "This is how it starts!" And I'm not sure why. And the very end shows that Barney Ross is way too forgiving. There's a world's difference between the caliber of acting on hand. Some of the better actors, Jason Statham, have bigger parts. And even for having a small role, Mickey Rourke way outshines Randy Couture. The Expendables is billed as a grand send-off for the action genre, which, let's be reasonable, is on life support thanks to an infestation of comic book-inspired blockbusters. Occasionally, there are some quality explosions and stunts, my favorite involving Barney's plane and its deceptive arsenal. And for those into nostalgia, you get to see some familiar faces. Stallone's is so pumped with I don't know what that you can't even find a wrinkle. But at least he doesn't look over the hill. The Expendables is nowhere close to being the best of its kind. It is, however, a ceremonial victory lap. I give it 2.5 out of 4 stars. I'll see you guys next time. Hey, so I got an idea to work on a question and answer video. It's like the only kind YouTube will actually let me make money off of. So here's the story. Send me a question you want answered as a video response to this review on YouTube. I'll see what I can do.